Hey guys, my name is Zaim Javed and I'm back with another video. So in this video we'll talk about how I built this Quillbot AI clone. So this is exactly how Quillbot is. So if I open Quillbot, I have changed just two modules. So instead of co-writer, we have the blog writer here for some limitations from the OpenAI, and for citation generator we cannot implement it in through OpenAI's API because it would have to connect to some internet. So the OpenAI's API does not have any, or its models does not have any access to internet. So that's why we cannot do the citation generator. So we have made this module here. So here is the original tool. It's just a little bit different, but we have most of the functionality working. So let's start here. So if I show you, if I give it any text that it needs to paraphrase and I click on paraphrase, it will give me the paraphrased text. It will also show me the input words and the output words as well. And then you can click on copy and the text will be copied here. So if I paste it here, you can see that the text has been copied. So what I'll be showing you in this video is how all of this functionality is working. So let's move to that. So if I show you the walk around, so I have made the template very easy to understand. So if I go into reveal elements, so there's header, a sidebar, and then a dashboard simply. So the sidebar is collapsible. So if you have to add any tab, you can simply copy paste this. Okay, so let's go through each of the module like paraphraser or grammar checker, and then we'll go through all of these six modules and we'll see how this is working. So before that, we need to make sure that we have a plugin installed. It's called ChatGPT and that's from Chakor. So if you search for ChatGPT simply, you can see it comes on the comes here. So it's by Chakor. It's called ChatGPT. So we have used this plugin. After that, you have installed your plugin, you have to come into this URL. You have to be signed in, as I'm currently signed in here, and you can set your payment methods here. And afterwards, you can come into your usage limit and set your usage limit here. And then after this, you have to generate your API keys. So if you come into here, you will be able to generate your API keys from here, as I have just generated. Please keep in mind that these are the keys that you need to put into the plugin. So if you come here, the keys, you have to set it as bearer and then this, and then you can come into design. So let's see how the paraphrasing is working in this. So you just need to open dashboard, and then you can see the first module named paraphraser. So it opens up here. So if you click on start edit workflow and see how the paraphrasing is working, so we are simply sending ChatGPT the prompt that comes from user. So this is the prompt that we sent it, and then we are just saying to ChatGPT, so to OpenAI, that paraphrase this text, as simple as that. And then the max token is equal, so the max tokens, you can learn more about them on OpenAI's website. So if I go through it quickly, 100 tokens can be equal 100 words, or 100 tokens approximately equals to 100 words or tokens, 700 words or tokens. So I'm not sure about that, but you can learn more about them that on the OpenAI's website. So tokens are exactly how you get charged. So please make sure that to save your cost, you can decrease this number down to anything. We are simply displaying its data that comes from, so the ChatGPT ask question, and then what we are doing is result of step two's choices, first items, text. And then what we are doing is it comes with slash n slash n, so it has a space on it, And so we have to do find and replace slash in slash in, and then we have to use regex pattern. If you do not use regex pattern, these spaces will still show up. So you need to have this here. So this is how the paraphrasing is working. And the grammar, so we are just saying that resolve spelling and grammar mistakes in this text, and we are just passing it the input that comes from here. Afterwards, let's move to the blog writer. So this functionality remains the same everywhere, but with slight changes on the blog writer. So if you go to the blog writer, so if you click on write blog from here, you have to come into the blog writer and then click on write blog. What we are saying is, it is write me a blog of x number of words. So we take the input from here, like user inputs any amount. It should not be an empty amount, it should be some number at least, and then we are passing that value here. So we are saying write me a blog of 50 words on the topic of, so the topic will be defined here. So let's say we wanted to give us 50 words blog on global warming. We can actually ask it to give us 200 words, and we can ask it to write blog, because the 200 words are a lot, so it takes a little bit of time. So you can just simply copy this text that you have gotten now. So if you copy this text, so if you paste it here, you can see that this is a 200 words blog. Okay. And then let's move to summarizer. So the summarizer functionality is also the same. So if you click on summarize button, it will say summarize this text that user will input here into this word. So summarize this text that we input here to, let's say, 50 words. So it will summarize this in 50 words for us here. So if we say it summarize, as you can see, it has summarized us. So these are not exactly 50 words, these are 64 words, but still pretty close to 50. And then what I'm doing is that for max tokens, I'm just simply inputting the number of words from the input. So from here to then 20 plus. Okay, so if we move to the legal documentation generator, so we can say generate me again 200 words legal document on the topic of. Okay, so if you now click on generate button, so this is the complete prompt that you can see here. So if you now click on generate, so you can see that it gives us almost 287 words essay, and it also misses some of the information from the top, but you can really get a idea of how it works. And then if you come into the translator, you can get any language here and then let it translate from here. So if I say it, so if I give it anything here, let me just copy this text and come into translator. I'll set it to detect language, and then I'll say convert it into Urdu. So this is the language that I natively speak. So if I let it translate, so so it has correctly translated it in Urdu. So let me show you the functionality of how the translate works. So there are two, so the translate, I have a database here called languages, and in this table I have added all of the languages here. And for the detect language, what I have done is I have added a new language here called detect language and made a zero here. So this is because the names are getting sorted by A to Z, so the zero will come first, so the detect language always remains first here. And then what I'm doing is, if I show you translator, what I'm doing is I'm finding and replacing zero from the current options caption. So you never see the zero on front end. It's just on back end and for, so it's just a technical thing. And then what I'm doing here is that you have to set some language here. You cannot make it empty. So if you click on translate, so there could be two scenarios. The one is that user selected a detect language, and then there's a use case when user has actually selected a language from which we have to translate. So in case user has selected detect language, our prompt will be different. We'll say translate this text from unknown language. So and we'll input the input from here, that will come from here into here, and then we'll say to which language. So it will be Urdu. So we'll pass the drop down. So we'll actually pass this language from here into here. So the so we'll say translate this text from unknown language to Urdu language, and then we'll say and then we'll pass the input from here in this prompt, and we'll set it to 400 max tokens. You can increase it. I think you can increase it to some 2k or 4k value. And the same for and almost same for the other scenario. So if user has not selected detect language, it means that he has selected some language like English. So if I go into the English here, and I can say that translate this text from language value. So it will get here. So it will get English, and then to this language. So to this language, and then we can pass the input value from here. So this is the input that we will pass it. So this is how the template is working, the Quillbot template, and it is completely mobile responsive as well. So you can use it in mobile as well. Alright, this was all about Quillbot clone that I have just built. So if you have any queries about the OpenAI's API and how it is all working, please do let me know in the comments, and I will definitely get back to you there. Thank you so much.